Geobyte.
Hi students, welcome to the Geobyte Diploma series. In the last video, we have discussed some problems. Now, in this video, let us discuss how to find the total change in length of a bar with different cross sections and stress for the each section of the bar which is maintaining different cross sections. I took a bar which is maintaining three different cross sections. For that, assume this is the section 1 of length L1, diameter D1. Similarly, this is the section 2 of length L2, diameter D2. This is the section 3 of length L3, diameter D3. And the total load acts on the body is P. According to our diagram, you can say that the load in the section 1 is equal to load in the section 2 is equal to load in the section 3, that is equal to P. If I assume the three sections are made with different materials, since Young's modulus is the material property, E1 be the Young's modulus for the first cross section, E2 be the Young's modulus for the second cross section, and E3 be the Young's modulus for the third cross section. Then the stress in the first section, stress in the first cross section or first section may be denoted by sigma 1 is equal to P1 by A1 may be in Newton per millimeter square. Generally, we are taking the area in mm square. Similarly, stress in the second section, stress in the second section, sigma 2 equal to P2 by A2, it is also in Newton per mm square. And stress in the third cross section or third section, stress in the third section may be sigma 3 equal to P3 by A3, unit may be Newton per mm square. That is how you can find the stress in each and every section. But for this particular case, since the load remains same, the section which is maintaining the least cross section is maintaining the maximum stress. Once again, for the same load carrying capacity, the section which is maintaining the least cross section is maintaining the maximum stress. Similarly, total elongation or total change in length, delta L equal to change in length for section 1 plus change in length for section 2 plus change in length for section 3. That is how you can decide the total change in length. You know, change in length general formula, PL by AE. Therefore, delta L1 equal to P1 L1 by A1 E1. Similarly, delta L2 equal to P2 L2 by P2 L2 by A2 E2 and change in length for the section 3 P3 L3 by A3 E3. That is how you can decide the change in length for different cross sections. After finding the change in length for each section, you add them for getting the total change in length. I hope you clearly understood. With this information, let us take a problem. Yes, look at the problem. An axial load of 25 kilonewtons is acting on a bar consisting of two lengths are shown in figure. If Young's modulus is 2 × 10⁵ Newton per mm square, determine the stress in each section and the total elongation. Look at the diagram. Since the D1 L1 given for the smallest cross section, therefore the smallest cross section can be taken as 1 and the largest cross section is section 2. From the diagram, L1 200 mm, L2 250 mm, but load remains same, total load remains same. It means P1 equal to P2. Let me write like this. P1 equal to P2 equal to 25 × 10³ newtons. And only one Young's modulus is given. It means indirectly the two cross sections are made of same material. E1 equal to E2, that is equal to 2 × 10⁵ newton per mm square. L1 L2 given, D1 D2 given. Now let us decide the area for cross section 1 equal to pi by 4 into D1 square. D1 is given 20. Simplify this value. For getting the A1 is 100 into pi, it is in mm square. I decided the A1 value in terms of pi. Similarly, area of cross section for section 2, pi by 4 into D2 square. D2 is given 30 square. Simplify this value for getting 225 into pi is also in mm square. Then stress in the first section. Stress in the first section sigma 1 is equal to P1 by A1. P1 equal to P2, that is equal to 25. 25 into 10 rest 3 divided by A1. A1 equal to 100 into pi. The resultant value. The resultant value is 79.58 newton per mm square. Similarly, stress in the second section. Sigma 2 equal to P2 by A2. P1 equal to P2, that is equal to 25 into 10 raised to 3 by A2, 225. The resultant value is 225 into pi. Should be very careful. The value is 35.36 Newton per mm square. So look at the sigma 1 and sigma 2. The stress in the section 1 is 79.5. Stress in the section 2 35.36. The sigma 2 is less than sigma 1, or sigma 1 is more than sigma 2. The reason for that is, look at the section 1 and section 2. Though the load remains same for both sections, since section 1 is maintaining the least cross section, it is maintaining the maximum stress. That is the reason the stress developed in the section 1 is more than that of section 2. Now come to the total elongation. Total elongation delta L equal to change in length for the section 1 plus change in length for the section 2. Delta L general formula, PL by AE, then delta L1 equal to P1 L1 by A1 E1. P1 equal to 25 into 10 raised to 3 into L1 equal to 200 mm. Divided by A1, I got is, A1 is 100 into pi, E1 2 into 10 power 5, simplify this value for getting delta L1 is 0.079 mm. Similarly, change in length for section 2, P2 L2 by A2 E2. P1 equal to P2, that is 25 into 10 raised to 3 L2, length for section 2 250 mm, divided by A2 equal to 225 into pi into E2, 2 into 10 power 5 Newton per mm square. Simplify this value for getting 0.044 mm. Therefore, total elongation delta L equal to delta L1 plus delta L2. Delta L1 is 0.079 plus delta L2 0.044. The resultant value is 0.123 mm. That is how you can decide the change in length for the bar maintaining different cross sections. Similarly, let us take one more problem. Look at the next problem. A bar of uniform cross section of diameter 20 mm. Though it consists of three sections, all the three sections are maintaining same diameter. It is like this. D1 equal to D2 equal to D3, that is equal to 20 mm. Find the total elongation of the bar and maximum stress in the bar. E is given, only one Young's modulus given. It means E1 equal to E2 equal to E3. that is equal to 200 kilonewton per mm square, it is equal to 2 into 10 power 5 newton per mm square, because 1 kilonewton equal to 1000 newtons. A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3 equal to pi by 4 into d square. It is equal to pi by 4 into diameter of the each section is 20 whole square. It is 100 into pi in mm square. 100 times the pi in mm square. Then let us find the stress. Since the area of cross section remains same, though the area of cross section remains same, the stress need not be same for all cross sections, because the load which is acting on all cross sections is not same. Let us assume this is the section 1, section 2 and section 3. Now let us take the section 1. For this section, the load is like this. This is the section 1. In the left end, it is 50 kilonewtons. Come to the right end. For the right end, 10 kilonewtons plus 60 kilonewtons. Both are towards right. But opposite to that one, 20 kilonewtons is acting. 20 kilonewtons. The resultant value, 10 plus 60 towards right, that is 70. 70 minus 20, the resultant value towards right is 50 kilonewtons. So this is the section 1. For that section 1, P1 equal to 50 into 10 raised to 3 newtons. Then stress for the section 1. Stress for the section 1, sigma 1 equal to P1 by A1. P1 equal to 50 into 10 raised to 3 divided by A1, 100 into pi. You simplify this value for getting the stress You simplify this value for getting the stress. The value is 159.15 newton per millimeter square. Similarly, let us find the change in length. Change in length for the section 1. Change in length for the section 1, that is delta L1 equal to P1 L1 by A1 E1. P1 is 50 into 10 raised to 3. L1 is given all lengths are in mm. This is the L1. L1 equal to 400. L2 equal to 1000. L3 equal to 800. All are in mm. So L1 is 400. Divided by A1. 100 into pi, e1 equal to 2 into 10 raised 5. Simplify this value for getting the change in length is 0.318. You are getting the change in length. The change in length what we are getting is 0.318 mm. Similarly, let us take the section 2. Section 2 is For section 2, length is 1000. This is your second cross section. L2 equal to 1000 mm. Now come to the loads. The loads are acting towards right and left. For this section also, for this end also like this. Now, with respect to right end, 60 kilonewtons is acting towards right. Opposite that one, 20, 60 is towards right. Opposite to that one, 20 kilonewtons. The resultant value is 40 kilonewtons, that is acting away from the ends. Similarly, other end, 50 is acting towards left, and 10 kilonewtons is acting towards right. It is like this. 50 is acting towards left, 10 kilonewtons is acting towards right. The resultant value is 50 minus 10, 40 kilonewtons. So P2 equal to, for the section 2, P2 equal to 40 into 10 raised 3 newtons. A1 equal to A2, that A2 equal to, already got it, 100 into pi. L2 equal to 1000 mm. Then, with this information, stress for section 2, sigma 2 equal to P2 by A2. P2 equal to 40 into 10 raised 3 divided by A2, 100 into pi. Simplify this value for getting the stress for section 2. It is 127.32 newton per mm square. Similarly, change in length for section 2. Delta L2 equal to P2 L2 by A2 E2. The P2 equal to 40 into 10 raised 2 L2 1000 divided by A2 100 into pi. E2 equal to E1, that is 2 into 10 power 5. You simplify this value for getting the change in length for section 2, 0.637 mm. Similarly, let us take the section 3. Section 3 is for the section 3, length is 800, load which is acting towards right is 60 kilonewtons. This is the section 3, load is 60 kilonewtons. Once again, let us go back to the problem. 60 kilonewtons, length 800. The loads which are acting towards left, 50 plus 20, these two are acting towards left. 50 plus 20, 70. 10 kilonewton is acting towards right. So it is like this. Both are acting towards left, but 10 kilonewtons is acting towards right. The resultant value 70 minus 10 is 60 kilonewtons. So P3 equal to 60 into 10 raised to 3 newtons. L3 is given 800 mm. And A3 is 100 into pi. It is in mm square. With this information, stress in the section 3 that is sigma 3 equal to P3 by A3. P3 is 60 into 10 power 3 divided by 100 into pi. You simplify this value for getting the stress 191 newton per mm square. And change in length for section 3, delta L3 equal to P3 L3 by A3 E3. P3 equal to 60 into 10 raised to 3, L3 800 divided by A3 100 into pi, E3 2 into 10 power 5. You simplify this value for getting the change in length for section 3 0.7 64 mm. Therefore, total change in length delta L equal to delta L1 plus delta L2. Delta L1 is 0.318, so delta L1 0.318, delta L2 0.637, delta L3 0.764, 0.318 plus 0.637 plus 0.764. Simplify this value for getting 1.719 mm. That is the total change in length. You are also asked to decide the maximum stress developed in the section. You are also asked to decide. It is like, find the total elongation of the bar and the maximum stress developed in the section. Look at the sigma 1. Stress for section 1, 159. Stress for section 2, 127. Stress for section 3 is 191. Since the all sections are maintaining the same cross section, the load which is acting on the section 3 is more. The stress developed in the section 3 is more. Therefore, maximum stress is developed. Maximum stress is developed in section 3, and its value is the 191. Look at the value, 191 newton per mm square. 191 newton per mm square. That is how you can decide the total elongation and maximum stress developed in the body. With this concept or with this problem, I am concluding this video. In the next video, we will discuss the remaining topics. Thank you. Thank you very much. GeoByte.